My name is Mark Schmitz. I'm the founder and CEO of SonoSkills. The goal of this presentation is to explain the concept of lifelong learning in musculoskeletal ultrasound and to offer you a clear overview of the path you can follow to become a competent qualitative sonographer. This article about the top 10 pitfalls that should be avoided when performing musculoskeletal ultrasound has been published in the European Journal of Radiology. It states that investing in equipment instead of education is a big mistake that can lead to misdiagnosis. This article confirms the many articles about experience dependency that have been published and state that one should first invest in continuous education and in later or simultaneously in equipment. I quote the author of this article: "A high-end operator using average equipment performs better than an average operator using high-end equipment. To get the job done, the priority of investment should be education, not equipment. So, if you would like to produce qualitative work in clinical practice, you should embrace the lifelong learning principle. Make sure that you improve enthusiastically as much as you can, with, as a result, a steep learning curve. Become a true specialist, not only because it's fun, but also because it increases your knowledge, your awareness of your own limitations, your confidence in clinical practice, and with all of that, you gain more success. Happy patients, more business opportunities, and financial growth generally follows after working qualitatively. Lifelong learning also offers you the chance to connect with musculoskeletal professionals, your peers, and expands your network. This also adds to developing your knowledge, your skills, and more business opportunities. At SonoSkills, we offer courses at several levels. Level 0, the introductory course, is optional. This course is designed for professionals who would like to experience a short theoretical and practical training of the possibilities of musculoskeletal ultrasound. If the professional is convinced that he or she wants to do a full basic course, then he or she can skip this introductory course and enroll in the basic course straight away. Very important to understand is that the Level 0 course is an introduction and does not substitute a full basic course. More course hours are needed to be able to scan in a qualitative way in clinical practice. Level 1, the basic course, is where it all starts. After completion of this hands-on course, the professional is capable of using musculoskeletal ultrasound in clinical practice in a qualitative and critical way. The professional learns how to scan anatomical structures of the upper and lower extremity. Scanning three-dimensional functional anatomy is the main goal of the course. Pathology recognition is also a part of the course, but a much smaller part. Before focusing on pathology, the professional should first have a good clue and knowledge about what normal anatomy is and what normal anatomical variations there are. Only if the professional knows anatomy very well can the professional start learning pathology. In level 1, the basic level, the professional learns doing it. In level 2, the intermediate level, the professional learns seeing it. That's the next step. The aim of level 2 courses is deepening the sonographic examination of the extremity joints, which have been discussed in the level 1 basic course. It is also expanded with additional positions to scan new anatomy. In a systematic way, all the structures around the joint will be imaged with ultrasound and discussed related to the clinical investigation. But more importantly, a lot more focus will be put on pathology training and pathology recognition. The results from scanning anatomy and pathology recognition will be placed in a bigger picture of clinical reasoning and clinical decision making. In level 3, the advanced course, the professionals learn to scan complex anatomy and recognize complex pathology in real patients. These courses are taught by true experts. This advanced level will make the professional a true specialist in the field of musculoskeletal ultrasound. At level 4, the professional will be trained at expert level. The skills in musculoskeletal ultrasound will develop to an exceptional level, which will greatly benefit clinical practice. These expert courses will always be international, as there won't be enough people in your country to fill such a course. After this course, you could be regarded as one of the top musculoskeletal ultrasonographers, a true key opinion leader in your country. A professional following these expert courses aims not only to work in clinical practice, but also pursues scientific research and speaking at conferences. To become a general musculoskeletal sonographer, everybody has to follow the level 1 basic course, in which the extremity joints are learned on basic level. After level 1, the professional continues to level 2, the intermediate level. At this level, the professional can choose from many courses that SonoSkills can offer. For example, the professional who mainly sees shoulders in his or her clinical practice might wish to follow the shoulder path. After having followed the level 2 intermediate shoulder course, the professional can continue the lifelong learning cycle at level 3, advanced level of the shoulder. So, after having completed the level 1, the basic course, the professional will determine and follow his own path of lifelong learning. Many paths to become a specialized musculoskeletal sonographer are possible. The courses in which the professional is not interested, or in which he or she sees no added value, do not have to be followed. Healthcare is rapidly changing. In many countries, healthcare costs are rapidly rising due to increasing healthcare technology, increasing numbers of people with a chronic disease, and increasing numbers of people getting older. This is a big problem for society. In order to help all people that need care, to shorten waiting lists, and to decrease the economical burden of society, the healthcare system is being changed. The hard line between primary and secondary care is fading. Primary care professionals take over certain work from secondary care professionals. This enables secondary care to focus on the more complex problems, and primary care professionals can deliver the same care for less money. With this, a new professional is born, the professional that works in 1.5 care. This is the primary care professional that has taken over some duties and work from the secondary care. An example is the family doctor who does certain medical imaging, like ultrasound, by himself. Or the family doctor who does small surgical procedures herself. Another example is the extended scope physiotherapists, for example, the ones who are working in the United Kingdom. The extended scope physiotherapist is also rising in other European countries, like, for example, the Netherlands. The extended scope physiotherapist is an added value to the medical doctors in secondary care. This physiotherapist is equipped to diagnose or evaluate more complex pathologies on a structural level. The extended scope physiotherapist is also allowed to do injections, for example, under ultrasound guidance. The extended scope physiotherapist will be the future. Everybody, all sorts of musculoskeletal ultrasound professionals, are allowed and stimulated to follow all levels of ultrasound training, whether they come from primary, 1.5, or secondary care. But if we have to draw a hard artificial line on which we of SonoSkills advise you to complete as a minimum, we would say that the primary care professionals should at least, as a minimum, be educated and trained at level 2, the intermediate level. Only being trained on level 0 or 1 is, in our opinion, not sufficient. For professionals working in 1.5 or secondary care, we advise a minimum of level 3, the advanced level, to be able to offer the quality that is needed to face the challenges of 1.5 or secondary care. But of course, SonoSkills likes to motivate you to pursue course levels as far as you can. All courses are open to everybody. Your professional background is not important. What is important to us is your professional attitude. We know that professionals who are curious, eager to learn, quality driven and motivated will most likely become competent sonographers at the levels they have followed. The learning curve is long. There are always courses to follow that will feed you with new knowledge, visions and skills. Before becoming a skilled sonographer, you will first have to learn how to do things before you will start to see things. Lifelong learning increases the reliability and accuracy of your ultrasonographic diagnosis, prognosis or evaluation. What I personally like about musculoskeletal ultrasound is that the older you get, the more experience you have. The older you get, the better you will be in musculoskeletal ultrasound. The field of ultrasound is somewhat contradicting to many other things in life where it gets harder or more difficult when you're getting older. Dr. Stefano Bianchi, one of the world's best musculoskeletal sonographers, is already at a certain respectable age. He is very experienced and may be therefore one of the world's best known key opinion leaders. I would like to conclude this presentation by quoting him. Every person can learn to become a sonographer, but you need dedication and passion. Thank you for watching.